Welcome back to the Cotton Bowl. Most of the fans have left. Obviously, they're turning out some of the lights. The Buffaloes turned the lights out on the Duck and Ducks, I should say. And joining us now is Oregon Athletic Director Bill Moos. Not quite the way we all wanted it to end.
Well, I'll tell you, we had a good year, and we've got a great future. We had a tough third quarter, but we don't need to hang our heads. This is a fine football program, and like I said, there's going to be many more great memories ahead for us.
You're an old football guy. You know how to analyze this thing a little bit, but that interception for a touchdown by Marcus Washington when Oregon was driving to take the lead had to be the key play in it. Did you sense anybody getting demoralized because of that?
Well, I think just from my perspective that we were in control of the game. We were moving the ball very well. We were in sync, I felt, on offense, and I thought the worst-case scenario coming out of that is that it would be 9-6 at that time, but that could have taken a little bit of spirit out of some of our people. But Colorado, you got to hand it to Colorado. They've got a fine defense. They're a fine football team, and I thought we would battle back, and it just didn't happen.
What do you tell Mike Bellotti and his staff after something like this?
Well, I already have, and I told Mike, hey, you've done a wonderful job this year. The players have done a great job. We've got so much to build on, and two back-to-back great seasons, and our recruiting is going well. I do feel that this is the beginning of a great football program at the University of Oregon, and there's a lot of people, even with the score the way it was, would like to trade places with the University of Oregon Ducks right now.
Yeah, that's for sure. Well, it's been a great year so far, and happy new year, and let's get on to basketball, huh?
We get on, and we're going to have a fine recruiting year. We've already had some nice commitments football-wise, and it's still a great time to be affiliated with Oregon. And, we're going to keep our chins up and get back with it.
I'm sure you will. Well, thanks for stopping by. I know it's been a tough day weather-wise and, of course, the score, but we'll see you on the trip back and next week in Eugene.
Thank you, Todd.
All right, Bill Moos, Athletic Director for the University of Oregon. When we come back, more from the Cotton Bowl as we wrap things up. So stay with us.
Well, all last week we had reports from Dallas about what a great time the players were having on their trip to the Big D. And then over the weekend we heard about what a great time the boosters were having after they arrived in Dallas on Friday. Now, Todd McKim and Randall Whipple are down at the Cotton Bowl, and Randall has a story about what some of the boosters did today.
Walt. These fans from Oregon that came down here for this football game had a tremendous experience. The game was very important to them. But I think what was most important to them was just being here together for the whole experience. And that certainly was evident this morning.
Oregon fans felt right at home arriving to rain and cool temperatures at the Cotton Bowl Stadium.
Having a good time in Dallas?
Having a ball in Dallas. I'm here with my baby brother, who is a Beaver fan, and I'm making him wear a Duck shirt.
So how's your Cotton Bowl trip been?
Great. Dallas has been wonderful. We've had a great time. Down here with friends and couldn't be happier.
Love your outfit.
Hey, thanks. We're ready to go.
Show us these earrings.
Oregon.
Kickoff was a couple of hours away. Time enough for a Texas-sized pregame party, Duck style. Support of the Ducks.
So he's down here, he's going to all the activities, having a great time.
Another fan chose to mail his message to the Husky coach.
Right. Says, dear coach, we're sorry you couldn't join us. And then I've got the scores for the last two games. Says, get used to it.
Pre-game appetites were big, especially for a victory.
Yeah, we're eating the bus. That's what we're eating the bus.
Apparently, this lone Colorado fan didn't know he was on the menu.
What on earth are you doing here?
Not much. I'm sitting around.
Bobs! Certainly speaks well for a Colorado fan, doesn't he?
Of course, the best way to chase a buffalo is on horseback, but it helps if you know how to use a rope. It's also a good idea to stop by the restroom. But like roping buffalo, that too is easier said than done.
They are not enough, believe me. We are staying in line, end line.
The Oregon crowd soon found their way into the Cotton Bowl Stadium, bringing with them a wave of enthusiasm.
Yeah.
We have pictures of Oregon fans in the fourth quarter watching a lopsided victory on the part of Colorado, but I think those pictures are best saved for another day.
Yeah, well, maybe burn them.
Right.
You know, what the heck. We don't even want to send them to Colorado.
There was plenty of fun to remember.
Yeah, there was. When we come back, we'll hear from the head coach, Mike Bellotti. Post-game show continues from Dallas.
Well, one of the interesting sidebar stories to the Cotton Bowl was the coaches. Both in their first year at their colleges, both went 9-2 during the regular season, and both looking for their first major bowl win, their first bowl win of any kind. Now, Oregon's Mike Bellotti, even after a loss today, 9-3, still not a bad season, especially for a first-year guy, right, Todd?
Oh, a heck of a season for a first-year guy, no question about it. Of course, Mike wanted to get that 10th victory. But
10 would have been nice.
It would have been beautiful, yeah, but 9 wins, that's not a bad place to start, that's for sure. After the game, in fact, just moments ago, Coach Bellotti had these comments about what happened today.
You sure it won't happen? It won't go to the top 10 now? Well, I think we're back to where we were. We know that we talked about it. We fought and clawed and scratched our way to this point, and we've been knocking on that door. We didn't knock it down. We got kept out again today. I think that this is a relatively young team. We only have 12 seniors. They're great players and they're great people. They've laid a foundation for us that we now have to build upon. And we want to be back here at this game or another game on New Year's Day next year. And we said the same thing a year ago. And I'll have the same message to this team that I did when I took it over, that our job is still there. We still have to prove some things to the people, and we still have to prove some things to ourselves.
We got a question over here.
What's your reaction to the first time with the fourth quarter?
No comment.
Next question.
Well, that's one of the very few times you'll ever hear Mike Bellotti give you a no comment. He's been very affable, very good with the media, but, you know, tough situation for he and his ball club this afternoon.
Yeah, he certainly wasn't making any excuses. Definitely a class act, and there is going to be a lot of controversy talking about that.
The fake punt.
Yeah.
Yeah, no question about it, but that's water under the bridge, so to speak. Now we got water on our heads. So, Walt, let's throw it back to you for now.
Okay, thanks a lot, guys. When we come back, we will wrap it up from the Cotton Bowl, so stay with us. You know, the Ducks have never finished the season ranked in the top 10 in the country. They've only, the highest they've ever been ranked was 7th. That lasted just 1 week back in 1964. They hope that a win today would have got them into the top 10 when the final poll comes out later this week. But that's not going to happen now. The question is, how far will they drop? A couple places, probably. Let's go back to Dallas one more time, where our three amigos are standing by with some final thoughts on today's game.
Freezing by.
Yeah, freezing, that's for sure. First of all, Randall, let's start with you on the final comments. Your thoughts about coming down here. You know, you don't get to cover football teams very often, but you did get a chance this week.
There was a lot more to this whole experience than just the game. And the fans came down here. Talking to Dave Frohnmayer earlier today, he talked about just how valuable this whole experience has been for the University of Oregon. And I think that's going to pay dividends for a significant time to come. On the heels of last year's Rose Bowl success, the Cotton Bowl, maybe the third time's a charm.
Yeah. The Ducks' disappointing finish to what had been an outstanding season, this close to the best season in Oregon history. No other team in the 100-year history of Oregon football has won 10 games. They finished 9-3, but hey, there's a goal for next year. That 10-win season is still within reach.
That's right. They keep taking steps, and I think what we're seeing here in the Oregon program is 6-7 years ago, they were just happy to get to the Independence Bowl. They leave today disappointed in losing on a New Year's Day bowl. This program has showed improvement. The other thing that I take away from this is the Pac-10 currently, with one game in progress, is 0-4 in bowl games. And I think there has to be some serious questions as to whether or not the Pac-10 has lost prestige around the country, because it has not been a good showing. In fact, all four Pac-10 teams play very poorly. I think that's a bigger question for the Pac-10. But for the Ducks, disappointment, yes, but a great season. They certainly have many more building blocks upon which to build than they did 6 or 7 years ago.
A very young team, as Coach Bellotti said. They only lose a couple of seniors, a lot of important players back next year.
Well, that wraps it up this week for our coverage down here in Big D. We hope you've enjoyed what we tried to bring to you, capture the flavor and the essence of what this Cotton Bowl was all about. So for Randall Whipple and Pat McGilvery, Bob Warnick, Barry Johnson, and of course our photographer, Ken, he's done a great job for us all week. He's been rolling the tapes. Ken Boyer, great job. And for all of us, thanks for watching. Stay dry. Happy New Year.
Happy
Back
New
to
Year.
You, Walt.
Hey, you guys, have a good trip home. Just as a footnote, you know the weather's great in Eugene today.
You need to roll the tape in the truck
today.
Now. Get ready to roll the tape. Roll that tape. No.
Well, okay. They'll, for anyone who's interested, not many of the players will be on the plane tomorrow because they're all coming from different spots, but team plane expected to arrive at about 2 o'clock tomorrow at Neyland Suite.
Listen as your day unfolds, challenge what the future holds, try and keep your head up to the sky. Lovers, they may cause you tears, go ahead, release your fears, stand up and be counted, don't be ashamed to cry. You gotta be bad, you gotta be bold, you gotta be wiser, you gotta be hard, you gotta be tough, you gotta be stronger. All I know, all I know, love will save the day. Herald what your mother said, read the books your father read, trying to solve the puzzles in your own sweet time. Some may have more cash than you, others take a different view. You gotta be stronger.